Hello everyone and welcome to the PythonInvest.com YouTube channel. This is the second video about sentiment analysis of financial news. We will extract relevant financial news through an API and get an aggregate sentiment on the set of news. Why do we need this? There can be several reasons. For example, you want to trace your favorite stocks or companies or even whole industries, and you want to get all news that were issued about them. Another reason can be when you want to check if highly positive or negative sentiment actually causes or is correlated with the stock performance. How we will do that? So we are going to use a NewsAPI wrapper in Python to get the set of news. Then we will use Vader library to get the sentiment numbers. And then we will look at the specific example of a Tesla stock performance in late April 2021. Great, let's start. First, we are doing the imports. So we are running PIP install NewsAPI-Python, PIP install YFinance to get the financial data. We are importing NLTK library, and if you're running it for the first time, we need to download Vader lexicon to make the library working well for the English language. Then we import a NewsAPI client and a sentiment intensity analyzer, and we initialize sentiment intensity analyzer in a variable called SIA. And the last thing, we set option to display full width of the text when we print text from pandas. So next step is to obtain an access key for the NewsAPI. I will run a cell here. I won't open it not to expose my personal key, but you can easily get a free key by registering on the website newsapi.org and obtaining this key for yourself. So I store my private API key in a variable called NewsAPI key. Next, we try to call and get the list of stocks. List of articles about some query. So here is a NewsAPI object, which is a NewsAPI client with the key provided. We have a keyword called Tesla stock. It is important to add a word stock, because otherwise you might get not very relevant articles as an output. And then we have a date. So this is a date 1 month ago, 10th of April 2021. And then we make a call by calling function get underscore everything of the NewsAPI object. So we provide keyword, search keyword as a parameter, and other parameters like from date to date, which is exactly 1 date after the from date, language English. We sort by relevancy and we define page size which equals to 100 articles maximum. We do not want to see here articles published in other languages, because we might need to translate them in order to make the sentiment library work with all of them. And we also do not provide the list of sources here, but you can do it if you want. If you have some favorite business newspapers, or some set of newspapers that you are following. as a result, you will get an array of articles. Each article is a dictionary, and it has such fields as author, content, description, published at, source title, URL, and URL to image. Next, we will get sentiment on a description. I've randomly selected four different descriptions, and I iterate phrases in that set of descriptions, and where I print the phrase and the polarity scores from the sentiment intensity analyzer for that specific phrase. For example, our first phrase, well, this week news broke that they had been in talks with Twitter for a $4 billion acquisition, so it looks like they are still pretty desirable. And we see that positive score is 0.3. It is quite high. I can't understand why negative score is even higher, which is 0.6. So you need to think what metrics to use for your analysis. I use here only compound score, which is 0.76, which generally says that this article is quite positive or quite strong. There are other phrases like, wow, how things change. It is positive because of the word wow. There are neutral descriptions like former DHS Secretary Janet Napolitano spoke with Yahoo Finance about comprehensive immigration reform. So we can't say if it's positive or negative. And the neutral score is higher than negative or positive score, and compound score, which is a combination of three previous scores, is quite low. So any metric here lies in the interval from minus one to one. So one, for example, compound score, when it's close to one, it means that it is a highly positive text. If it's close to minus one, it is highly negative text. So last but not least, let's look at the at one example. If you go to any website showing the stocks prices, you will see that Tesla stock had a spike of around 10%. Started after Friday 9th of April. And here we want to check what was the news coverage for that. Probably you are not able to guess the initial moment for the stock, but if news papers write about it in a highly positive sentiment, maybe it makes more people to buy the stock and drive the prices even higher. So here I have a function called get article sentiment, where I provide a keyword, search keyword, start date, sources list, which is a none by default, and show articles equals to false. This is a debug option. If I make it true, it will show me all the articles in the returned by the NewsAPI. So I create a NewsAPI client. I have two different calls, whether I provide sources list or not. And then when I get results from the call stored in variable articles, I start to analyze its text. I take only title and description. So here is a variable called article content, and then I call a sentiment intensity analyzer and only compound polarity score. And as a result, I return a data frame which shows me a compound sentiment, URL, title, and description. So here is an example. I have a Tesla stock started at 9th of April. And I make a distribution of sentiments. I calculate a mean of sentiments, which is 0.33, which is more than zero, and it is quite positive. I get a sentiment count, which is 69 articles on the topic, and article description, just to check what do I have. So I see here from articles description that actually those articles are about Tesla and they are relevant. By looking at the histogram of sentiments, I can see that there are very few articles with a negative sentiment, which is less than zero, maybe 10 articles overall. Then there are 12 articles having neutral compound sentiment, and there are many articles with a moderately positive or highly positive sentiment. So this piece and this piece. Now let's check the examples of articles. So let's see the most negative articles, minus 0.87 sentiment. They are saying in description that it is more risky to not own shares of Elon Musk. So they are asking the question, but the algorithm thinks that the actual description is about negative proposal not to own stocks of Tesla. Next article is not directly related to Tesla, at least with description and title. So let's look at two most positive articles. Here we see some positive descriptions and titles, but the problem is that I don't see any mentioning of a Tesla company or Tesla stock here. So any analysis like this should be taken with the bits of thought and with a grain of salt, and you should carefully check what you get with the news API or with the sentiment scores that you get. Thanks for listening. See you next time.